Hi guys, today I want to show you how we can use Smexoscope to get better compressing. I have a kick that wasn't punching through the mix, and let's see how we fixed it. First off, we have Smexoscope here, and I'll AB for you to have an idea of the initial and the result. As you can see, you can also see that initially, without any compression, the kick has a very big belly. It doesn't really punch through the mix, has not much of an attack. With the compression, it looks really, really better. Let's see how we ended up with this kick. Let me get a compressor here. And the key to this is to think about what you want to achieve. You want the attack of the kick. You want it to go through the compressor. And let's turn off the makeup gain. We don't want the compressor automatically bringing up the gain. And if we look at the kick without any compression, we bring down the attack to a reasonable level that the transient goes through. We want a very big release, and now the ratio, let's have it at 3:1. Now, I'm gonna bring down the threshold so that the kick gets compressed and we can hear what's going on. What I'm looking for here is that I can hear the attack going through, that knocking sound, and now I'm bringing down the release to compress the tail of the kick to the level that I wanted. And we can hear that it's already better, but we can also see that it's already better. That's the magic of the Smexoscope. We have a very nice attack on the kick, and now the belly of the kick is in line with the rest of it. We are at minus 13 dB. We were at minus 10. For that, I'm bringing in a utility. Nice punchy kick, and let's see it in context. The utility bring it back to minus 10, even 3 dB slower, and still going through the mix really nice. So that's it. A quick tip on how to use Smexoscope to get better at compressing. It's really easy, and visually you can understand what you're doing. Bye, guys.